budget and the issues raised. We've got Dr. Tunji Ogunyemi, who is a budget historian. He's also a senior lecturer in Obafemi Awolowo University, Ile-Ifa. Thank you for coming on this morning.
Thank you, Chambali.
Well, yes, just before we head into this budget, I mean, this news that's making the rounds about the OAU professor who was sacked for marks. Yes, commending the school authorities how they've been able to look into this matter. Amazing. Well, they shocked and surprised a lot of people how they handled it. But looking at the whole scenario, we know that there's a lot of backstory to all of this. But what's your impression of this?
Oh, well, thank you, Chamberlain. First of all, I would like to say that I'm a budget historian and a legal practitioner, and I want to show some reticence in making any comments on issues that has to do with staff and students. I believe that you'd be in the remit of the public relations officer of the university. It's a thing that the Senate of the University has pronounced on. Once the Senate of the University, the Obafemi Law University, has pronounced on an issue, that is the final word. No other comment can be made by any academic. That's the final word.
Okay, on the part of the school?
Yes, on
the
part of the university.
Also mean that, you know, the lecturer will not have any rights to appeal the case?
Oh, every Nigerian can challenge. You see that the university said they did not say they found him guilty. They said court people. Only a court of law can find a Nigerian citizen guilty of an offense. Only a court of law. And it is without prejudice to the right of Professor Akindele to seek redress in the court for appropriate actions. But that's just within his purview. And I would like to restrain myself in order not to compromise that opportunity.
Mm-hmm. But I mean, were you surprised when you heard it, for instance?
Going by the honor, integrity, name, and history of OAU, a university founded by some of our greatest, some of our best, you would have felt pained. And I did feel a lot of pain when I heard this. When I also heard that the university senate stepped into the matter almost immediately, apprehended it, and took actions it considered in its own judgment as most appropriate, then I felt some relief.
You are in that university as well as he is. Have you met him one-on-one? Do you know him? Could you tell us, if you do, could you tell us what kind of person he is?
Again, Gimba, I would like to say that I would not want to go further. I know Professor Akindele, yes. You know, Professor Akindele is a very senior colleague. He's a senior colleague.
I know this topic is put you in an uncomfortable position. So, but sometimes we ask these questions because we just want to find out the other side, a bit of the backstory.
The backstory are within the public sphere, they're within the public spaces. It's within the public space. Professor Akindele is professor of accounting.
Okay, talk about accounting. Let's go look at the budget.
Yes, thank you.
So, All right, so looking at this now, even though the president was not happy while he was signing the budget, he complained about the insurgents, and some of the dailies just listed a long list of some of those insurgents. But the main move is now, wait a minute.
President Muhammadu Buhari arrived.
And so it's not exactly a new thing on the part of both of them now, the executive and legislature. In fact, the response from the legislature is that we are not a rubber stamp. When you submit the budget, we need to look at the budget. So from what you've seen going back and forth, what do you think?
Yes, the National Assembly, of the Federation has acted in line with its constitutional mandate to look at the estimates of revenue and expenditure as provided in Section 81 of the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, 1999, as amended. So, and that section of the Constitution is clear. It permits and grants the authority to the National Assembly to set the manner by which those estimates of revenue and expenditure shall have to be done. In other words, the National Assembly can tinker with both the maximum and the minimum expenditure limits that are provided in the estimates, in the budget estimates. It's within its purview.
To tinker, but is it right for them to insert new items.
Yes, that's why I use the word tinker. See, the National Assembly is not established by the Constitution of the Federal Republic as an alternative executive arm of government. It is to do the work of making legislation. Three words. One, to legislate, that is lawmaking. Two, oversight functions. And three, representation. Any other function that the National Assembly performs outside of these three functions are overstretching the mandate. So it is not within the purview of the National Assembly to set up an alternative budget to the budget laid before it.
Does this look like an alternative budget?
Yeah, of course. Because I checked it and I discovered that the National Assembly have added more than 6,000 projects. 6,000 projects of its own, which will mean that it had done the costing, it had done the conceptual framework for those projects, it has also done what is called political balancing of the projects. I don't think the National Assembly has the wherewithal to be able to do all this.
But you said something about the National Assembly, one of the functions being representation.
Representation, yes.
And their own argument is that what the executive put out there is not, how do you say it now, in line with the desires of the people they represent. So they're just doing their part, representing the people. So they have to ensure that the people get what they desire. That's what they inserted. Don't you agree?
I disagree. If you apply that to Nigeria Defense, Nigerian Security Agency Act, what Nigerians demand or what Nigerians want, will the National Assembly also implement the same under Nigeria's defense, under Nigeria's security issues? There are certain technical issues that are beyond the purview of the National Assembly to look at. There are certain issues. And when it comes to building an alternative budget, such as it has done, look, it has not just inserted 6,000 of its own, more than 6,000 projects of its own. It has expunged more than 4,000 of executive budget.
Does this
By what authority has it done that?
But as you just said, let me follow up very quickly on that. Does it portend any grave danger for economic growth and development
if we have this? Of course, grave danger. It immediately gives investors the impression that we are not serious. That we are a country of working by default rather than by design. I mean, you don't run a nation progressively by default. It has to be by design. You have to be able to say that XYZ conditions given will produce XYZ results. It should be possible. But in this instant case, we have a situation in which the National Assembly had turned itself into an alternative executive arm of government in rewriting the budget. It can set the maximum.
Rewriting?
Of course.
Is that what was done?
Of course. I mean, you insert 6,000 projects. I mean, if you insert 6,000 projects that were not previously done, that means you would have gone to the market to do the costing. And in doing the costing, it takes nothing less than 6 months of executive preparation to be able to project, including environmental impact assessment. Did the National Assembly have the instrument to do environmental impact assessment of constructing roads, constructing bridges?
Well, you know, this matter, because year on year this issue comes up about what limits does the National Assembly have. You say they've got the right to tinker.
To tinker, yes. With the maximum and the minimum expenditure limits. In other words, if the government says we are going to spend 6 billion, the National Assembly can tinker with it and say, sorry, I think going by the income profile of the country, I think we should spend about 5.6 billion and not anything. It can tinker with the maximum and minimum. With respect to existing and already laid projects, not in creating a new set of projects. That's my take.